Hey everyone, today we are checking out Grandscape in the Colony here just north of Dallas. We were here last week for the Jurassic World exhibition, and there's so much other cool stuff to do here. And we've never come up here. We've lived nearby. We're gonna start our day with Electric Gamebox, so we're gonna find out what that's all about. If you guys like what you see, please like and subscribe and share. We are going to be putting up new travel videos, fun things to do all the time. I'm Jake.
I'm Emerald.
And this is Farmeritaville. This feels a little like Disney Springs with less magic. There it is, Electric Gamebox, straight ahead. We've made it to Electric Gamebox, immersive digital adventures with friends. Let's go see what it's all about. We're getting checked in here at Electric Game Room, and I don't know what to expect. It's not an escape room. It's not an escape room. It's I don't know. So we're definitely gonna let you guys know how it goes, and I don't know yet if they're gonna let us video inside. I'm gonna try to, and we'll see what it's like. But the lobby's great. Lots of cool aesthetics.
Show me lights.
Emerald really likes the color-changing light bars. They got lockers to put your stuff. And here in Texas in summer, most importantly, it's air-conditioned.
Air-conditioning!
There's only one guy working. He's checking in some other people, but we can see footage of the rooms, which look very plain and white. But I don't think that's what they look like when you play.
Items on the floor. Trust me, someone will trip over them. The adventure will contain flashing lights and loud noises. You probably will need to be able to hear it. All sessions are monitored and recorded for your safety. So don't do anything you could do in front of your parents. The door could remain unlocked, but please stay in the main box at all times. In the help area, tap this icon on the wall to call for a member of staff. If you hear a fire alarm, you'll pause your adventure. Assembled and await instructions from our team. And finally, due to social distancing measures, we ask that you remain in the game box at the end of your adventure until a member of our team gives you the all clear of the intercom to head to the exit. Thanks for listening. It's time to play.
Please stop by your installer.
It really feels like that episode of Black Mirror where everybody was a slave that had to ride like exercise bicycles, and they lived in cubicles that blared loud commercials, and the only way to skip the commercials was to spend some of the money you made by riding bicycles.
I'm your host for today. My name is Adrian McBride. I drove my 70 for this day.
Always listen to your wife.
Yes.
Ooh, you were right. You're kicking my butt.
What museum is that?
Guggenheim National Gallery, BBC Arts, Acropolis.
I don't know.
Wait. I'm gonna guess Guggenheim.
No, it says something museum. Yeah.
And I guessed right.
Yay, you did it!
Moral of the story is always guess.
No. Oh, I know this. He's my favorite.
It's like, come on. That one's easy.
Who is the music this flag?
Well, now they're playing the pub music too. Incoming call.
What's that?
Is it WhatsApp? You're way cooler than I am. Clash of Candies. Things to go together on these three walls. CrossFit, sometimes they're on the same wall. What do we got?
Dollars and cents.
Spring break.
Home run. And yearbook. Okay.
All right, we just finished our hour-long session at Electric Gamebox, and I had fun. Did you have fun?
Yes, I'm very sweaty. But you should definitely stretch if you're over 25 before doing some of these games. But it's not that difficult, and it was super fun.
It wasn't quite an escape room, but there were some escape room puzzles on one game where you had to work together and you had to move around each other to navigate. I'm watching one wall and she's watching the other wall, and we had to navigate around each other without falling in the water. And so like that, there's like teamwork, and then there's like straight up trivia, which is kind of cool, like pub trivia. And the answers are on the walls all around you. And then the dragon race game was not fun. We had to run and jump and climb and no. But it's all digital, it's all immersive, it's all video mapped all the way around you. So it's definitely worth checking out. I think it was like $15 for an hour. So I mean, it's cheap too. Yeah. So come do it. This is the first US location open in Grandscape at the Colony, just north of Dallas. There's more locations set to open, but as of right now, this is the only place you can do this in the US, so definitely don't miss it. There's a lot of great places to eat here. Barley and Bread is one, and none of them are busy because we're here on a Monday, and Monday is definitely the time to go do stuff. If you work in entertainment or hospitality or the service industry, you frequently have Mondays off, and Mondays are the time to go do stuff. Everything gets busy on the weekend, especially Saturday. So if you can avoid going to fun and games and excitement on Saturdays, I would recommend not going on Saturday. Seven Doors food, which we have never tried. We're going to try some lunch. They got sushi. I'm excited. This place is great. And Monday afternoon, nobody here. Perfect. I am trying the frozen hibiscus margarita because margaritas, hello. And at the bottom of the drink menu, they tell you about the Seven Doors. So named Seven Door. Cool. That looks amazing. And M got
the Mexican Mule.
The Mexican Mule. She's got tequila in it.
Yeah.
Hibiscus frozen margarita. Delicious.
Gimme, gimme.
Oh, this looks amazing. We got a tuna tower and the avocado roll, and this is called the sushi thing. And I can't wait to lay into this. And you got the ruby trout. Ruby trout, ruby salmon.
No, ruby trout.
Ruby trout, had it right the first time. Cut that part out. All right, Seven Doors at Grandscape is amazing. If you're a foodie, definitely try it out. And I hate to use the word staycation, but this felt like vacation eating. The food was excellent. The drinks were excellent. The service felt like I was at Disney. Like, Layla was so awesome. She took such good care of us. So definitely, I got nothing but good things to say about Seven Doors. Come try this place out. Did you like it?
It was bitchin'.
We did Electric Gamebox, and then we had lunch at Seven Doors, and now we are gonna go check out Shields All Sports. Shields is apparently a giant sporting goods store, and I think this is their first Texas location, maybe the first location down in the South, I'm not sure. But from what I saw briefly on the internet right before coming here, there's a lot of stuff to do inside. And I hope they don't take it as a sign of aggression that I'm wearing a Bass Pro hat today. That wasn't planned, that's just the way it happened, so we'll see what happens.
Fishies.
You love fishes.
I do. You're welcome. Thank you. Look at fish. Love shoes.
Cool. They're so stripey.
Dory.
Right. There's a Ferris wheel in the sporting goods store. I think every sporting goods store should have a Ferris wheel.
I just don't know how it relates to sports.
Dude, no, I don't know. I don't know.
I can understand how it relates to sports.
Hardware, and it was the first thing I got to buy new because I was the last of six kids and I got all the hand-me-downs. That glove is about as meaningful to me as anything.
I want to put a quarter in it and ask it for advice, but it just keeps talking about sports statistics, and I don't know anything about sports statistics.
I had the opportunity to be a teammate of Tom Seaver for 4 years. We went all the way to win the World Series.
Robo Emmett Smith does not appear to be awake. It's his day off. Nolan Ryan is doing all the talking.
Happy to be physically, but it's me. It's my voice.
Oh, he's awake.
This is my thoughts. These are my thoughts for you today. Who would have thought that? Even though there was a goal, doesn't necessarily mean I was going to be able to achieve it. But when you cross over that threshold, and no other man has crossed over, that's me. Yeah. I was touched by an angel.
Do you think when they were getting the taxidermy giraffe in here, they bonked it, and it's why its antlers little like meh, and then they were like, corporate will never know, just put it up, shh, let it happen, man, let it just, we gotta get this open.
I think the giraffe guards the Ferris wheel.
The giraffe is clearly over your ship.
can do all of our shopping here.
Yeah.
This is like Nebraska Furniture Mart with guns and golf clubs and a Ferris wheel.
Oh, this is that made out of that composite packing stuff, so it doesn't rot.
They have a welcome gnome.
But composite decking stuff, so it doesn't rot.
I like this stuff.
They have sheeps. It's sheeps. Oh wait, do they have little tiles?
M says, if we're ever millionaires, I get to have tiny bowling in the house. So right now I get to look and drool at clothes to tiny bowling. This is the largest dart selection I have ever seen. Customizable darts. I have never been in a sporting goods store where you could buy your own disc golf goal. And they've got everything you need for disc golf. And for the exotic hunter who's tired of killing normal everyday woodland animals, you can get a Sasquatch practice target. That's funny. So that was our tour of Scheels, which is the biggest sporting goods store I've ever been to. And that's weird because we have Bass Pro Shop here. We have two Bass Pro Shops here and they're massive, but this had a restaurant, it had a furniture store, it had a toy store, it had a candy store, it had a bike shop.
And a Ferris wheel.
Ferris wheel. You know what they're missing? Boats. Scheels, up your boat game. But of course, we didn't leave empty-handed because that's how we roll. We bought crap. And but yeah, definitely check out Scheels. Lots of cool crap to do. And guys, if you liked having fun with us today, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. We're going to have a lot more fun travel and attractions and things to do videos coming up really soon. We're going to try for one once a week. So keep watching and hit that notification button. Got any suggestions for other places around DFW that you want to see us check out? Then leave it in the comments. All right. Thanks for watching.
Go do stuff.